of the repelling game was trust.
I got yours. I picked you up because you were wrong. You were wrong and you confirmed it.
$35,000 was at stake. This is the closest you're going to get to it. What is your answer?
Mistrust Fuller.
That is correct.
Way to go. Way to go.
Good job.
Who's not having an exemption?
Once again, I was not a part of the exemption process.
Patrick. A group of strangers working together to earn up to $1 million. That in the end, only one of them will win. One of these players is the Mole, a double agent we hired working for us against the other 13. At the end of each episode, the players take the quiz, 10 questions about the Mole. The quiz determines who stays and who goes because the player who scores the lowest on the quiz is executed and sent home immediately. Up to $1 million hinges on discovering who is the Mole. Watch for the clue to the identity of the Mole in tonight's episode.
It's weird being here and having no exposure to the outside world or current events or anything.
It has been so long since I've seen my wife and kids. And I am wearing down.
I was feeling guilty about coming here with Mom very ill.
I miss home. I want to go home, but damn it, I want to win this money. I want to win this game. And I know I can do it. I know I can.
After 14 days of isolation, our players find themselves in Vicenza, Italy.
I think it is time for a game. I need three players who are swimmers, three people who are runners, and one person who likes to talk.
Oh, I like to talk.
This game involves seven people. The three people who are not picked will be staying here at the hotel. The other players will just have to tell you what went on.
So my hand shoots up. I like to talk. And then I get Darwin behind me.
Okay. I think Katie should be the talker.
It's like, you know, you've done so many great things already. You know, you shouldn't be involved with this.
What do you mean? All right. You've done the last two big things.
I think most of the time, since we have been so unsuccessful in winning these games, we want to get the best players in. And with Katie, it was really just fairness. I don't think that Katie's a better talker than Al. I just thought that Katie may participate in this game.
All right, so Al, you're staying, is that correct?
Yeah.
Over there. So Katie, you are the talker. You three are the runners. You three are the swimmers.
Yeah.
Okay, follow me.
As they're walking away, I'm sitting there and I'm thinking, I'm just getting madder and madder at the comment that he made. I'm like, why the hell is he picking on me?
Why me?
You got Rob and Bill. And those guys participated in the last game. He didn't say boo about them. They won the last game.
What I'm pissed off is if they freaking offer another exemption, I'm going to be so angry.
Well, in this game, Katie finds herself back at the blackboard, being a school teacher, right where you belong.
Definitely.
For this game, the players will be asked four questions dealing with the history of Vicenza.
Now, runners, it's your job to actually find the answers to the first three questions. You'll find those answers somewhere in the town of Vicenza. Once you find the answers to the three questions, they will be placed here. Answer one, answer two, answer three. You'll then have 15 letters that are in boxes. Those letters have to be unscrambled and placed here. Now, once you unscramble those 15 letters correctly, you'll get the answer to your fourth and final question, and $20,000 will be added to the pot. Now, I'm not going to be timing this game. Swimmers, you guys are basically the ticking clock. You will be in the pool treading water. As long as one of you is treading water, the game is still in play. There is, however, a catch. Every 5 minutes, a weight will be added to a swimmer.
Oh.
As you're there treading water. If you all stop treading water, game over. All right, runners, this is your phone. Your car is waiting, so go to it.
Good luck, guys.
Good luck, guys.
And so, load me down with the weights.
And he's had experience swimming a mile with, like, full flight gear.
Yeah. Right. When I swam the mile in a flight suit, I swam on my back the entire mile. It took me an hour and 40 minutes.
See, you'll be fine.
Our strategy is to have Bill take most of the weights because he said he was a strong swimmer. After he drops out, I take as many weights as I can so that we can keep ribs fresh for the final leg of the game.
No. Cause I think I have, I mean, I have pretty good endurance.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, the three runners, armed with only a cell phone and map, wait for their first question.
All right, swimmers, please get in the water.
Woo-hoo! Woo!
Get into position. You guys ready?
Yep.
All right, here's the first question.
Hello?
Rob, okay, here's the question. Next to the Tempio di San Lorenzo, there is a statue of a poet. What is his name? Ready? Go.
Only one runner may go at a time, and they cannot take the map with them. They'll have to rely on their memory to find the location.
All right, it is about that time. Who wants the first wave?
I'll take it.
How heavy is it, Bill?
Well, it feels about 15 pounds.
My question was, there's a statue of a poet. What's the name of the poet? And it was very nearby. I got lost. I went the wrong way at the very first. The map was upside down. I went the wrong way. I got lost.
All right, 1,100 meters.
Bill, you all right?
Oh, my God. How heavy was that weight?
A lot of letters.
Make use of those legs, though.
Guys,
book.
I've got it.
Think,
woman,
ah.
Think.
Pulls
out.
Come on, Rob.
Giacomo Vanella. Giacomo Vanella.
Okay, who's going to want the... We have about a minute left. Who wants the next wave?
I think...
Bill drops out after 8 minutes, and I'm worried about how long I can last, because if he can't tread water with one weight around his neck, I'm thinking that I won't be able to either.
Bill, I thought, was a shoo-in for hanging in there for, you know, at least 4 or 5 weights, and I don't see how he couldn't last more than 8 minutes.
I'm just not very good at treading water. If I could have traveled, got on my back, I could have stayed in there for a while. I don't know how long.
Hello?
Olavia?
I just want to let you know we have one swimmer down.
All right, bye. One swimmer down.
What?
One swimmer down already?
Yeah.
Who went down?
I don't know. I didn't even ask.
Who's gonna take the wave?
I'll take it.
Yeah, stick in there, my friend. I missed you guys.
Katie?
Yeah, what's the answer?
Giacomo.
G-I-A-C-O-M-O. Zanella. Z-A-N-E-L-L-O.
No, I'm sorry, that's not correct.
It's not correct.
What do you mean it's not correct?
It's not correct.
How did you spell it?
G-I-A-C-O-M-O. V-A-N...
No, Z, Z, Z.
Z?
Z.
Okay.
Zebra.
Z-A-N-E-L-L-O?
Yes.
That's not correct.
What? It's totally correct.
He's got the wrong statue.
Oh, my God, what is the answer?
Try an A at the end.
A, as in Anderson.
That is correct.
Here, I guess it was Vanilla.
Give me the question.
Here's your second question.
Okay, directly behind the Arco del Scaletti, how many stairs lead up to the top of the hill? Okay, bye. How'd you know that was an A?
Because I'm the mole.
When the first weight was put around my neck, it didn't feel very bad at all. However, the effect of the weight around my neck grew exponentially.
Hang in there.
You guys, it's going to be a little bit, because there's a lot of numbers. This directly behind the Arco del Scaletti, how many stairs lead up to the top of the hill? So she has to count.
Try to figure it out right now.
So once we knew it was a number question, it was all spelled out, we tried to fill in the blanks.
You could try 87-2. Try the 2 first.
That is incorrect.
Okay.
After about the 4th wait, is really difficult to keep your head afloat. Every third stroke, I'd take in water. When I was trying to pull a breath in, I would get water instead, so I'd have to cough and keep my head above water.
Come on!
My run was extremely difficult. I ended up getting lost, and I asked several pedestrians where the arc is, and no one knows where it is.
That is incorrect.
I really just started losing energy and felt nauseated.
The fifth weight is added and I'm extremely tired. I can take one more weight. I'm giving Bribs an extra 5 minutes.
Kitty, you've got to be able to go through every single combination. 28, 38.
30 seconds for the next weight.
Okay, 23.
Okay, 33.
With over 6 pounds of weight on him and having tread water for 35 minutes, Darwin drops out.
Good job, Darwin.
With Darwin and Bill out of the game and Dorothy missing, Bribs is their only hope. Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
Tell her to run quickly. Go.
I'm hurrying as fast as I can.
Good job, Darwin.
Two questions are still unanswered. Now, only Bribs can keep the game going. But he has been treading water for over 35 minutes. If he quits, the game is over.
Dorothy's gone, and somehow they just figured out the answer there at the swimming pool.
You have the correct answer.
Woohoo, we got the correct answer.
This is your third question.
Oh my God.
Hey, Olivia, I figured out the answer with the help of the swimmers. We got one swimmer left. We need to be fast. Which famous author's tomb lies in the Tempio di Santa Corona? Don't fret. The answer is just outside the front door.
Tell her to run quickly.
First way.
Bribs has now been in the water for 40 minutes and receives his first weight. Can he last long enough for the group to find the answers to the two remaining questions?
Bribs, how are you doing?
We'll be a lot better once we get the answer.
I know.
My question was, find the famous writer who is buried at Tempio San Corona. I kept picturing Bribs in the water. I'm like, oh my God, he's probably like, you know, drowning by now.
Keep it up, Bribs. You all right?
Come on. Make sure we have all the letters on the other side.
Okay.
To start doing the final. Let's get that set squared away.
Permiso.
Che scrittore? Come sapete?
Luigi Taporta.
P-O-R-T-A.
These are all the ones that we know that are in there.
Are you sure?
Yeah. L-A-L-A-O-E-O-E-E-T-E-E-T-E. Hey. Okay, what's the answer?
Luigi D-A Porta. P-O-R-T-A.
D-I or D-E?
D as in David.
E as in apple.
That is incorrect.
Okay, that's L-U-I-G-I-D-A-P-O-R-T-A.
Uh-huh.
Incorrect.
That's not correct.
Maybe I'm spelling it wrong. I asked one of the locals, that's what they told me.
Porti, porte, porta, porto, door.
That is correct.
Woo!
Let's go.
The first three questions are answered. Katie is now given the fourth and final one.
Their love was sealed with, quote, a righteous kiss.
Romeo and Juliet.
The answer is in Italian.
Romeo and Juliet.
Romeo and Juliet in Italian.
Katie must now take the 15 letters from the boxes and use them to answer the final question.
We gotta go fast.
I know.
Julia. Juliet.
We don't have a J. We don't have a J. We have an L, we have an I. I'm missing a letter.
Do we have all the letters?
Yes, we have all the letters. Okay, so.
Although Katie insists she has all the letters,
she's in fact overlooked one.
Come on. I'm hurrying as fast as I can.
Not in the south.
You have the right idea. You are looking for how to spell it in Italian.
Tulia, Mulia, Mulia.
Because only swimmers still in the pool can help solve the puzzle, Darwin and Bill can only sit helplessly and watch.
Romero. Romero.
I tried my best to give as much output as I could, but I was absolutely exhausted. I couldn't breathe anymore, let alone shout out answers to her.
I can't do it.
I'm hurrying as fast as I can.
Okay.
I'm trying. Please.
I can't. Rick, you can't do it.
Just stop. I can't figure
it out.
No! Parks!
Gabe.
Rick, you all right?
You almost got it. You were right about Romeo and Juliet. The G was missing, so you needed the G, and you had it in the wrong order. So it should have been.
Forgetting the G is going to be something that looms larger and larger, and I will find it suspicious.
It seemed pretty obvious that Romeo was the last word, and if you have the last word, it's only a matter of spelling, and she's a teacher, so she should be able to spell Julieta.
Katie, how can you not be suspicious about that? It was the only G, the only G.
I feel like an idiot. I didn't see the G. I went through and I counted, and I never moved the G over. I never did.
So what, you got this wrong?
I went through and I double-checked, thinking I had all the letters, and I must have looked here, said G, thought I had a G over there, and I never did.
What was up with the misspelling?
I thought I gave Luigi da Porta. When I went to the church, there was nothing in there. I had to go and ask people in Italian, you know, what famous writer is buried in this church. It's not like it was written on a statue or anything like that.
It's obviously a tough game. Some pretty amazing efforts on some people's part, in particular Darwin Bribbs. Bribbs was in the water for an hour and 13 minutes. At the end, he had 6.5 pounds of weight on him. So very, very nice job. Around here, they say that Luigi da Porta actually wrote Romeo and Juliet. He allegedly came up with the story. People say William Shakespeare is a scoundrel because he stole the story of Romeo and Juliet from the true author, Luigi da Porta. And very few people actually know that the real Romeo and Juliet actually lived here in Vicenza. So anyway, lost the game, did not earn $20,000 for the pot, but good effort and certainly a lot of questions were raised. So let's think about that as we head for dinner.
All right. Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
Maybe you shouldn't try to run the show.
I wasn't trying to run
the
show.
No, you did.
No, I wasn't.
No, you did.
Why would you single me out of everybody else who wanted to participate?
I don't know. I had a real problem with Darwin and what he had said and the way I was feeling about what he said, and I couldn't go through another day of not saying something, so I was gonna have it at the dinner table in front of everybody, but I was gonna have it with him.
Well, maybe you shouldn't try to run the show.
I wasn't trying to run the show.
You did.
No, I wasn't.
No, you did.
I wasn't trying to run the show.
I'm not gonna sit by, and I'm gonna let you sit there and say, well, Al, you don't need to be in it. Well, who the hell are you to say who should be in it?
I didn't say you didn't need to be in it.
No, you did, man. You don't even know what you said.
Well, I tell you, if there was a there's an Olympic event for jumping to conclusions, Al would be champion of the world.
Can I explain my thought process to you? I simply thought that we were going to come to a consensus on who was going to do the talking thing, because I figured the talking thing was going to be the head honcho thing. And my thought process was, okay, he's the head honcho for the matchmaker. He was head honcho on the dam. Well, maybe we should give Katie a shot because you got to do these two great things.
What's happened with Al is that he is getting so serious in the games, or in talking about the games, it's sort of a life or death thing.
I was just upset because I was like, damn it, man, I'm sitting again. This is day three that I'm on my ass. And I was pissed because I don't want to be on my ass. I want to get out there and do stuff.
Darwin's kind of a take charge guy. You know, maybe he thinks that he can call the shots here. And I'm going to make it clear to him that
He doesn't call the shots when it comes to me.
I apologize. My intention was not to take over.
Then I understand what you're telling me. I do. I understand your reasoning behind it. As long as, you know, you weren't trying to slight me in any way, that's
absolutely
okay.
Not.
That
absolutely not.
The way you're thinking is okay.
All right.
I'm okay with that.
Put it there.
I'm glad we cleared it up, and I hope it's water under the bridge.
Hey, Brady.
They say, hey, come over here. So I walk over there, and on the door of the van is a message from the mole.
Oh. Mighty Goliath took a big fall. David or defeat, it's your call.
So wait,
Okay, wait, there's...
They're missing G's.
They're missing G's.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there was something amusing about that message. If you're a masochist or a sadist, all the G's were missing, which is actually what killed us the day before from winning $20,000.
So what do you think that means, guys?
I think it's your call is going to be the clue.
Mighty Goliath took a big fall. David or defeat, it's your call. David defeat. Slung a rock at Goliath's head, and that's
it's your
kill.
Call.
Dropped.
Is
David.
That what killed?
Yeah. Are you a being rock. Sarcastic?
Yeah.
Maybe they're just saying use your wits rather
they
than your
like
strength.
You.
Right.
Yeah.
All right.
With clue in hand, Al, Heather, and Myra, who sat out yesterday's game, head off to play a game of their own.
Welcome. Come this way.
I hope there's no Blair Witch thing going to be going on, man.
Incentive to try to win this next game. Here's how it works. Each of you will be in a cell. If anyone can get out of the cell within 3 hours, you win the game and earn $40,000 for the pot. The key to get out is right here. Okay? And everything you need to get this key is either in your cell or somewhere around your cell. You can assist each other or swap materials in any way you like. You get the key, you can unlock the lock. The extra incentive is that tonight at the hotel, all the players are going to be having a teleconference with their loved ones. If you get out of your cells, you will be able to take part in that teleconference. If you don't get out of the cells, you cannot take part in the teleconference.
Phone home at this point is extremely important. We're almost to the breaking point where it's been over 2 weeks and, you know, having zero contact with anybody from home is, it's really starting to wear on you, so.
I wanted out. I wanted to talk to my wife.
So I'm going to be taking these torches with me. And if this light bulb goes out, all the incandescent light in the room will go out as well. If there is a black light, you will be able to see the key. That's it. It's pretty basic. All right, are you ready? Your 3 hours begins now.
Okay, what do you guys think?
You know how that key's coming down. The light's getting broken.
Yeah, I know. We forgot the black light, though, and see, it's going to shine. It's neon green.
Exactly. You've got a slingshot over there that needs to be retrieved, if it can be. And we'll take that slingshot, bank the light,
that's where the
smash
freaking
the light, and it drops in the bucket.
Just grab a whole bunch of rocks. That's where the David and Goliath thing comes into play.
I got my wife in my back of my head going, Al, slow down. See what everybody else has got before you break that light. What's going to happen after that key falls? What are you going to do then? You know, because they're going to have no lights. So I'm like, okay, babe, I hear you. And so I wait till we go and I go, what do you got over there?
Yeah, they're trying to come up
exactly.
with a plan.
You had a hanger.
Yeah, I got the hanger. I've got this little rope of rocks. I'm taking the pillowcase off.
I've got a hacksaw above my cage here with these vines, and that's about all I could see in my cage. Myra says, well, I've got the slingshot here on the wall, and I've got, a rock strip hanging from this other thing on the wall. She takes a piece of her cot out and has a little stick, and she finds, like, a strap.
I really think we need to use our shoelaces. They're gonna come into play somehow.
What are you doing with the shoelaces now?
I'm just getting them off just in case I need
just a rope. In case. I mean, just be ready for anything.
We got 3 hours.
We're gonna
need
the light.
I wanna get out of here.
Yeah, so do I, but...
I'm gonna get that slingshot, okay?
Okay.
Listen, Myra, I need to get this hanger to you somehow. Because
okay.
This hook can go, but if I throw it to you and it doesn't make it.
Just aim and throw it at me, okay? Lean out, Heather.
Yeah, just
lean
out. With Heather
hey,
and
guys,
just throw
seriously,
it.
If we don't make it, it's it.
You'll
that's
make it. It's just a short toss from the front
I'll
of the
get
cage.
It.
Calm down.
Okay.
So All right, see? Okay, now we got it.
Heather throws me the hanger, and with shoestring, we start making a long stick, because we're going to need that.
The bottom line is we need to get that slingshot. We need to break that light. If we hit that light flush, it will drop into the bucket.
Yeah, but we got to get the bucket then to us.
Lara, how are you making out of that, honey?
Okay, what I'm going to do is throw my blanket out there, okay, to where I can reach it. I'm going to try to get the...
You're going to stretch out the blanket so if it falls off, you can drag the blanket back?
Good right. idea.
Smart. You got to get close. You can get closer to the wall. No. Hey, you're getting a lot of good rocks in there, though.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. There you go.
Okay. How's that?
That looks good.
Okay. Help me out here. Can you see?
I can see you. That's it. That's it. You're there. Hook.
Oh,
hook.
You got it, Myra. Yes. You got it.
Okay.
All right. Take your time. Take your time.
Now going from the inside. Yeah, there you go. From behind it.
You got it. You got it. Woo!
All right. You're getting somewhere.
Oh, my God. Whoa.
Now we have to retrieve the bucket.
I've got the basket thing down.
You know what?
Look.
Heather says, you know what? I'm going to drag the basket in. She ties her shoelaces together. She ties one to her shoe, and she's like, I'm going to throw the shoe into the basket, so when the key lands in the basket, I can pull the basket over.
I can hook it with this. The wood.
Well, I'm just going to land in there just
in
case.
Let's just, you know what, Myra, I think probably the hardest part is going to be...
I got it.
She's in. I think the hardest part is probably going to be breaking that light. We may take us 2.5 hours to hit that light bulb.
Yeah, let's start working on it. Look, I got the basket.
You got it in there. Plus, I'll throw the blanket near there, just in case.
Why don't we all throw our blanket out
Good.
So it hits the key?
Excellent. Get those blankets on the ground.
Very
if that
gently.
Key goes on a blanket, somebody's dragging it home.
Right.
Look at that, huh?
Oh.
That's how you lay a blanket. That's like a picnic.
There, perfect.
Okay, that looks
leave
good.
It like that.
So now we're set up. Now we've got the shoe in the basket. We've got a slingshot. We figured now we can break this light because now we can get it in here.
Okay. Let me just see what this does. Okay. I think I'll have better luck with the throwing it, okay?
She actually attempts to use a slingshot and realizes it's just a prop. It's not really useful. So we just start throwing rocks.
Check this out.
Okay.
How did I miss? I threw 10 of them.
Oh, I got it right dead in the middle and didn't break the big rock.
You got it.
Yes.
I got it.
Okay, it fell in the basket. It fell in the basket.
It did?
Yes.
Boom, I hit that thing.
I got it.
Get me home, baby.
Yeah. We did it.
That's what I'm talking about. Open that bad boy up and get us out.
Slowly. Take your time doing this.
There, I got it.
Break me out, girlfriend.
Woo-hoo! All right!
Yeah!
Hold on.
Okay. Great job, Heather. Stay here for a second.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
She did a great job breaking out. Heather, since you're the one who actually has the key, I have an offer to make to you. I'm going to offer you an exemption on the next execution. If you take that key and walk out with me right now, you'll be leaving these two in the cells overnight. That means you will be able to teleconference with your boyfriend. They will not be able to teleconference with their families. You still earn the money. No matter what, you guys have earned $40,000 for the pot. The money's guaranteed.
I do not want to spend the night in this cell. But we all know how badly Heather wants an exemption.
You now have to make a choice.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
Like, have you been worried about me, or are you just haven't really...
Yes, I'm going crazy. It's the worst thing ever.
Heather must now make her decision.
You now have to make a choice. If you want the exemption, you have to take that key, walk out with me, leave these two here in their cells overnight. That means you will be able to teleconference with your boyfriend. They will not be able to teleconference with their families.
Okay.
So?
I'm not gonna take it. I'm gonna let them out.
Are you?
I'm sure.
Just make sure you know what this means.
Yeah, I understand. There's no way. We did this together, so. I'm letting them out.
Yeah, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. There's no way I'm leaving you guys in here.
That is so huge. It wouldn't be forgotten. Let me tell you something, that wouldn't be forgotten.
We did it. We did it together.
Why did you passed up on an exemption?
Yeah.
Kind of unheard.
I know.
That's Heather.
It wasn't even a question in my mind. I would never have taken that and left them here. I know how important it is to me to talk to my boyfriend, and I can't even imagine wife, sister. I mean, there's just no way.
I have wanted an exemption up to this point extremely bad, so it's pretty ironic that this opportunity came up the way that it did, because it really wasn't a choice for me. I mean, I can't imagine anybody doing that to another person.
And if you get executed next?
If I get executed next, at least I know that I did the right thing. I don't want to leave. I'll do everything in my power not to, but it wasn't worth one more round to leave them here.
Yeah.
Shut up, Anderson. Give me a break.
Warming my shriveled little heart.
Not bad.
Not bad!
Later that evening, Al tells the others of Heather's selfless act.
And Heather didn't even hesitate. She said, I don't want the exemption. He said, sure, and she just kept moving. She said, I don't want it, I want them out. She poured no an exemption.
You're for so us. Getting a tote tonight.
Dad,
not that beautiful?
$40,000.
And we have broken the 200 mark.
Yes.
200.
Yes.
It's been a good day all around, and today is about to get even better for you all. After dinner, we've arranged for each of you a teleconference with a loved one.
Oh my God.
I must tell you, at that moment, I got extremely apprehensive. We have talked about my mother's health, and I didn't know how it was. All I can hope is that she's doing great.
Good. How are you guys?
Mommy?
Yeah, your picture
looks
really funny.
Hey! What's going on?
You see this?
Yes, I see that.
You look a little different.
Why? What's different about me?
You don't look like you have a mustache anymore.
I knew you'd hate that.
I miss you. Go back.
Should I just lose right now and go back?
Yeah.
Like, have you been worried about me, or are you just having a
really? Yes, I'm going crazy. It's the worst thing ever.
I talk about you all the time, and I brought pictures, and everybody knows who you are, and everybody knows everything about you.
Look, I don't know if you can see this. You see, look at the picture. I look at this picture every night and every morning. Every day I say good morning to you, and every night I say good night to you guys. Every night.
That's the in-between that I worry about.
No, don't worry about the in-between. Everything's okay.
Mama and I were joking that maybe you ran off to be in the CIA.
She probably thinks I'm in jail.
Maybe I should tell her you're in jail.
I should tell her that. She'll say, oh, okay.
What time is it there right now? Oh, I just
can't tell me. I'm not allowed to tell you.
Basically, the conversation turned to movies, and I found out that The Godfather is coming out on DVD. You know, if anyone else told me that on this game, I'm not sure I would believe them. So it was a good change of pace.
How are things?
Fine. Your mom is doing really well. Yeah, I spoke with Ruth this morning, and she said things are going great. So.
Fantastic. I'm glad to hear that. Thank you.
When I left home, it was under some very trying circumstances. My mother is quite ill, and so the real marvelous thing was hearing that she's doing very well, which is great. Yeah.
I'm so glad you called. I miss you and love you.
Love you, too.
Love you, sweetheart.
Bye, guys.
Love you.
Love you, too.
God, I miss her. I want to win this game, but I can't wait to see her.
Back in their rooms, Bribbs forms his first coalition.
You want to go through all the questions and apply them towards one person?
Darwin was like, you know, if you want the questions from the first quiz, let's go over it. You give me a sense of trust or an action of trust, and I'm going to help you out.
All right, so let's...
What color are the mole's eyes?
I put brown.
Where was the mole born?
I put Texas.
Oh, very sneaky.
I wouldn't say Darwin is necessarily the first person that comes to mind when I think about forming a coalition, but the more and more I think about it, it couldn't hurt, especially since I got his journal when we switched journals.
I can trust Bribbs to the extent that you can trust someone in the game. I don't think he's playing me at this point, but you never know. Can't trust anyone.
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
Any more card trick, Rob?
Yeah. You want to see on?
Yeah. If this freaks me out, I'm going to punch you.
What do you think? You think it'll...
Yeah.
What's his card?
Everyone can all see the initials, the Queen of Hearts.
Right. All right, so they go into the deck. So
take the deck, think about your card. Squeeze. It's Queen of Hearts, Queen of Hearts, snap. Queen of Hearts, now face up. I am actually enjoying spending time with everybody in the group. I think this is the group that's very tightly knit, and we all get along, you know, perfectly. And the best times we have are the meals, and that's when we get to know each other better, and that's when we get along the best.
So, Myra, did you talk to your sister?
I did.
Your sister, what's her name?
Carol.
Rob?
Back to my brother, Andy.
Bill?
My wife, Shirley. We were at the table, and Anderson was reviewing with us. He was asking who everybody teleconferenced with.
And Olivia? Who did you speak to?
I spoke to my boyfriend, Brian.
That's the first time his name has been said, because she's been reluctant to give up his name.
A name has emerged. The mysteries.
The
mysterious boyfriend.
I'm telling you, man, it's just something's up with this gal.
So, you now face your fifth execution. You'll soon be taking your fifth quiz about the identity of the mole. I want to wish you the best of luck.
It is time for the quiz. 10 questions about the identity of the mole. Question number one. Did the mole decline dessert after dinner at Al Pellegrino two nights ago? Number two. In town during the Think or Sink game, which runner was the mole?
I definitely suspect Dorothy to be the mole. I mean, she could still be in Vicenza right now counting the steps. We don't know.
Number three. At the pool during Think or Sink, what was the maximum number of weights the mole wore?
It seemed very unusual that Bill, the Navy Rear Admiral, was unable to stay in the water for more than 8 minutes.
Number four. During the Get the Key game, when was the mole released from their cell?
I don't want to think that Heather is the mole, because we have a coalition, but...
What she did was to put her shoe in the basket so that she'd be the one that gets the key. So if she was the one that got out, she'd look like the savior because she knew that the exemption was going to fall to her hands. And if she was a mole, why would she need an exemption?
Number five. With whom did the mole teleconference last night?
I spoke to my boyfriend, Brian.
Boy, that just seems a little too coincidental that she's never said his name until she absolutely had to. And then sure enough, there is a question on the quiz.
It's so subliminal that she could be the mole very nicely. She's my top pick amongst the girls.
Number six. In which room did the mole sleep last night?
Boy, as far as Katie forgetting the G, that's a tough one. I know it seems very suspicious, but I think it was completely unintentional on her part. I know she feels very badly about it. Earl, she's a very good liar.
Number seven, the mole was born on what date? Number eight, how tall is the mole?
Myra. Myra has recently moved up on my list just because she's quiet. She flies low under the radar. I almost forgot about Myra.
Number nine, does the mole consider themselves to be low maintenance or high maintenance? Number 10, who is the mole?
Anybody, it could be anybody. I don't think anybody here has a clear-cut idea of who the mole is.
You now face your fifth execution. Last two games have been split 50-50. One game you won, one game you lost. You earned $40,000 for the pot, which now stands at $206,000. There are no exemptions tonight. Heather had the opportunity to earn an exemption. She passed on that opportunity. So you're all vulnerable tonight. I'll be entering your names in randomly into the computer. And as always, after I enter your name, if a green screen appears, you remain in the game. If, however, a red screen appears, you are the game's fifth casualty. You have to take your bag and leave the game immediately. All right, let's begin. Dorothy. Katie. Al. ribs. Heather.
Sorry, Rob.
Hey, it's all right.
Take it back for you.
Not much I can say because I thought I was doing pretty well. So watch out. Just watch out.
Do you have any idea who the mole is?
I have no clue.
That just totally took my breath away. I didn't expect that at all.
He brought a lot to this group, and he will be really missed.
Those 9 people over there I think I'm going to be friends with, and I really enjoy this experience. So I look forward to meeting up with them again.
I got to say, that sucks to see Rob go, because he was definitely top 3 favorite people here.
All right.
Rob left, and he left on a high note. He left with one final joke. He threw the old Christopher Walken damn when he wasn't supposed to say a word, and we all started laughing. And I was laughing on the outside, but I was really sad on the inside.
There you go!
Nice job.
Woo!
Yeah! Yeah, baby.
Good job.
I mean, I can't think of one negative quality or negative thing to say about him. He was so great and so funny.
Hi, Rob.
Oh.
Come on.
I just think of his Christopher Walken impression, and it cracks me up every time.
You answer more than 4 questions wrong. It's burn back, but
my heart's now face up.
Take care. Say bye to Christopher Walken for me.
I will.
Rob, if you're home watching this now, dude, you're solid with me, man.